Hello and welcome on the front. My name is Matt, and on today's episode, we're going to be exploring the Nazi Castle of Doom. So let's go check it out. I am at Wewelsburg Castle, Wewelsburg in Germany, the castle that is often referred to as the Nazi Temple of Doom, as it was here where a lot of the Nazi occultism really took place, and it was actually the inspiration even for the very popular video game Castle Wolfenstein, a game which I myself still play today. The castle was thought by Heinrich Himmler to have mystical powers, and he wanted to turn the place into an area where the SS elite could meet to prepare themselves spiritually for future operations. It was never truly realized as this. In fact, only two such meetings ever took place, the last one occurring on the 12th to the 15th of June 1941, 1 week before they launched Operation Barbarossa and the invasion of the Soviet Union. It was during the meeting, it was reported that Heinrich Himmler had said to his SS generals to prepare themselves to eliminate some 30 million Slavs. Tragically, throughout the campaign, the Nazis would come very close to achieving this number. The castle itself dates back to the medieval period, but as it stands behind me, the architecture dates back to the 17th century. The castle is located very close to the Teutoburg Forest, and gives itself a little bit of a rise to some Germanic phantasm, and that was often attributed to the Arminius's defeat of the Roman legions. Arminius was a Germanic tribe leader who, quite famously, 2,000 years ago, destroyed defeated 20,000, Roman legionnaires in the Teutoburg Forest. The site of that battle actually is now believed to be about 90 kilometers north of here. Recent archaeology is to be believed. The castle itself has given rise to a lot of Satanist paganism and neo-Nazi mythology in the last 75 years since its liberation by the Americans in 1945. And it's become in some ways sort of a sadistic pilgrimage for, like I said, Satanists and neo-Nazis alike. So where do all these rumors of Nazi paganism and Nazi rituals all stem from? Well, let's have a look inside and let's find out. Much of the rumours that really sort of revolve around this place come from Himmler's own misunderstanding or misinterpretation of paganism and Germanic rites. Himmler desperately believed in magical powers, philosophy, and that the Aryan race were the superior people. And his SS were meant to be the very embodiment of that, in fact. And he desperately needed a place where he could bring future leaders of the SS to a central place and really drum these things home. And that's exactly what Wewelsburg Castle was actually intended to be. It was supposed to be a leadership school for the SS elite, and it was here that they were going to have these Aryan ideologies and race ideologies really kind of drummed into them. The castle was acquired by Himmler in 1934 for the symbolic rental price of one Reichsmark every year, and he had a 100-year lease on the property itself. When he took over ownership of the castle, he really wanted to bring in a lot of experts to try and back up a lot of what he was saying. So a lot of archaeology digs, all that sort of thing, really took up all around here, not only here, but also at the Exerstein and other spiritually important place, the Nazis. And the archaeology that was around here was, well, nothing. It didn't find anything that supported any of the claims of what Himmler and his pseudo-scientifics were really kind of putting forward, that there was an ancient Germanic race here before everybody else. So if they couldn't find it, what would they do? Well, they would fake it. In fact, this whole castle is very much so one of the biggest ruses in ancient history. Like I mentioned before, the castle is actually a medieval castle, but it was built in its current form in the 17th century. And in order to have Himmler achieve what he wanted, to have the castle turned into this medieval area spiritually for, you know, for leaders to come and meet, he needed to have it look the part. So during the renovation efforts, they actually stripped off all the 17th century plaster and replaced it with concrete and stone cladding to give the idea of it. In fact, the door behind me leads to the hall of the great generals, where you see the pagan sundial on the floor, the swastika motif on the floor, which is sort of what makes this place somewhat famous in that regard. Even that's all fake. The cladding on the walls is all, it's all concrete. And a lot of effort was put in by Himmler to actually acquire medieval artifacts and artifacts, and a lot of great effort was put into this, you know, almost this sort of like Indiana Jones style collecting spree, where they went around and tried to get as much information as they could in order to prop up their, you know, their false narrative of this pseudo religion. In fact, it's sort of what it kind of became. As the Nazis continued on, you know, from 33 to 39, they had a lot of issues with the Catholic Church, as a lot of the Catholic values didn't match up with what the SS in particular were really trying to do. So Himmler, along with his you almost call them pretend archaeologists, you know, in order to support his claims for a Nazism occult religion, with this falsified archaeology behind it, tried to create their own ceremonies out of it. In fact, they created their own Christmas celebrations. They also created their own wedding ceremonies. And some wedding ceremonies actually even occurred here at the Wewelsburg Castle under the new, you know, Nazist ideology. Also, this area became quite popular for swearing-in ceremonies for the SS elite. In fact, it was here as well that you know, they kept a chest of 11,500 rings of deceased SS members, and it was supposed to sort of symbolise the ongoing membership of the SS. You know, even after death, you never fully leave the SS. What happened to these rings after the war, though? Well, we actually don't know. Rumour has it that they've been buried in a nearby mountain, but the truth of it is that, well, we just don't know. The rumours of paganism and a lot of the occult that really sort of is said to have gone in this place, by most historians' accounts, is believed to be complete hogwash. It's sort of believed by most historians that no such rituals ever took place here. So, you know, all of these sort of, you know, pseudo sadistic sort of pilgrimage by people that come here is really all kind of for nothing. But what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to have a look inside the museum. I'm not allowed to film in there, what I was told. So I'll have a quick look around. Maybe grab some photos if I can, and then I'll see you when I come back out. Okay, so I just finished in the museum. Fantastic museum, I might say. I must say, actually, it costs about €3 to go in, and it covers everything from really sort of the prehistoric period all the way up until today, but it doesn't cover these sections of the Nazis, though. Now, that actually has its own specially dedicated museum, which is in the forecourt, which is the old SS guardhouse. We'll check out that area a little bit later on, but it's well worth the €3 if you do get a chance to come here and have a look. The plans for this castle under Himmler were immense. In fact, he the drawings themselves changed over multiple times, but the final plan for Wewelsburg Castle was so enormous, in fact, that they actually planned to relocate all of the Wewelsburg townspeople, and they were going to relocate them to the new Lebensraum, which had been acquired in the fighting on the Eastern Front, and the town itself was to be flooded, of course, you know, after the so-called final victory that was supposed to have been had. Now, of course, that never came. when the German army was defeated at the gates of Stalingrad in 1943, works of this castle were ceased. As after then a new decree came down that any sort of works that were seen to be non-essential towards the war effort were to stop. Works here subsequently stopped as well. The works here itself that were so immense that initially they were put forward or put together by the Freiwillige Arbeitsdienst, which is sort of the free-willing workers' force. But when the war broke out in 1939, all these personnel were then subscripted and forced into the German Wehrmacht. After this period, of course, Himmler turned to more sinister means of construction and actually purpose-built their own concentration camp just here to continue the building of the site. So let's actually now go have a look down on the ground level, if I can get down. I'm not sure if I can get down there, if I had to sort of film it from up here, and see sort of some of the immense work that these poor concentration camp prisoners had to perform. So I'm down now in the moat of the Wewelsburg Castle, and it was down here that the concentration camp prisoners were really put to task having to dig this out. Originally, the moat itself was not here. It was, as I said, it was a 17th century castle. Castles were already at the end of sort of their usefulness as far as any sort of real defensive work. But Himmler wanted to create the impression once again that this was a medieval castle that dated all the way back, you know, to the Germanic tribes and whatnot. So the moat here had to actually be dug out by hand by the concentration camp victims. We actually have behind me just here, we have a small memorial here to them. The triangles, which you can see, are actually represent why they were actually there. So within the concentration camp network, they had a hierarchy, and these hierarchies were often determined by what coloured triangle you were wearing. That would, you know, be the reason for why you're in there. So red triangles were given to political prisoners, pink triangles were given to homosexuals, green triangles to thieves, black triangles to people who were antisocial, so on and so forth. The Wewelsburg concentration camp was particularly brutal and had an extremely high mortality rate. There were around 3,900 prisoners kept in the concentration camp itself, and over 1,200 and I believe 29 prisoners were murdered there, either, you know, through the sheer exhaustion that they went through by digging out this moat, execution, starvations, I mean, you name it. I mean, concentration camps were horrible places. When the Nazis were defeated in Stalingrad in 1943 and the construction of the Wewelsburg Castle then began, or then ceased, the concentration camp prisoners were then sent off to other concentration camps throughout the Third Reich. And only a small contingent of 42 prisoners, along with their SS Guard contingent, were then placed to maintain the grounds here, and so on and so forth. What we're about to go on to now, so those concentration camp victims were then liberated along with the Wewelsburg Castle in March of 1945. Where I'm about to go down to into now is where they have the old basement of where we have the swastika, which is in the roof. I was told that I wasn't allowed to film in that, so I'll see if I can maybe get it in. Otherwise, I may need to overlay this with maybe an historical picture that I find. But you can only get to that area, at least at the moment now, because we're here during the Corona times. The whole monument or the whole exhibition here isn't actually open. You've got to go through that to get down into through the moat section here. So let's go in and have a look at that part. So I just came out of the Nazi or the Wewelsburg crypt there, and I managed to get a few shots there. So the crypt itself never actually had any, well, it has a really unknown use. No one really knows what it was going to be used in there for. The base of the crypt, some believe that it was going to be used as an internal flame. And, you know, there are always rumors of, you know, pagan rituals, taught lich ceremonies, that kind of thing. But you know, like I said before, it's all nonsense. Most historians are very confident to say that no such rituals actually ever took place here at Wewelsburg. The crypt itself, the northern crypt, which was the only section which actually survived, was never actually used. And that mostly because the construction was also never fully completed as well. So what we're going to have a look through now is actually, as we go back through, the museum which is dedicated to the SS and the atrocities and the crimes that they perpetrated here. So let's have a look at that museum. So come with me. Great photo, actually, here, an aerial photo. What we have here is the castle, we can see here, and then just up here to the north we can see the concentration camp, which was, like I said, purposely built to build this, what Himmler had envisioned for the place. We can see just how close it was to the Wewelsburg township itself. After I saw just how close this was on the aerial map from the museum, I thought I really had to come down here to see where the concentration camp was, and I'm standing now on where the memorial marker is of the concentration camp, which is designated by this triangle marker here on the ground, which again is to represent the triangles or the markings that were given to the concentration camp victims themselves. And of course it's all made up of smaller triangles itself. The concentration camp, or the location of the camp, now finds itself in the middle of sort of the Wewelsburg town itself. And there's no trace of the concentration camp itself on the site of really sort of where it used to be. But I thought I would just take a moment to come down here and see what was actually left of the location of the site. So I've just come out of the museum here, and I must say it was fantastic museum. I said that about a lot of museums. I think every museum I've come out of, I said it was fantastic, but that one I think was truly eye-opening in many different ways. Like I mentioned, the museum is located in the building behind me just here, which is was the SS guardhouse, which finds itself now located in the front forecourt of the Wewelsburg castle itself. That brings us actually to the end of today's video. Let me know your thoughts in those comments down below. What you think of the Nazi Temple of Doom or the Wewelsburg castle today? Do you think there were occultic and paganistic ceremonies celebrated here? Like I said, let me know in your thoughts down below. If you like this video, hit that like button. Of course, if you want more content from me, remember to hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time on the front.